Such a special experience during the years they spent there.
Yeah. My little brother.
Oh yeah, on the radio, yeah. But no, I thought it was on
TV.
Yeah, channel 26 is the channel 11.
It messes me up. I eat what I want, but it blows me up.
Hey, brother.
He looks like his dad, yeah.
Yeah. I thought he looks like his mom, man. He got that big one, go. He got that big ski jump like his mom.
I'm Ray LaCron, class of 45 and from the golden years.
Jerry Lagarde, class of 65, development director of Holy Cross School.
Jim Dotry, class of 55, I'm with the Jefferson Parish Sheriff's Office. I'm a major. Thank you very much.
This is L.A. Dotry, class of 55. Glad to be here with y'all. Thank you.
Raymond Conaway, class of 55, retired.
Bob Denny, class of 1956, retired editor of the Louisiana Conservationist magazine.
Creole gumbo, Caesar salad, charred almondine, and Tony's dish. Italian
lasagna, and breadfruit for dessert.
Also, don't forget the Christmas party. Start paying now if you want.
My name is Marvin Cavallino. I'm a graduate of the class of 1955, and I am a practicing pediatric dentist here in Metairie. And I enjoy these once a month gatherings just to see the rest of my classmates. I look forward to it.
Jim Apple, class of 55. It's good to get together with these guys, even though I'm not sure who half of them are.
Class of 57, Steve Arsenault, retired from the railroad about 5 years ago.
Fred Druant, class of 52, retired, petroleum engineer, and that's it.
Roy Phelps, class of 54, graduated. Retired from Bell South. And this is a hell of a good group here. And I appreciate you putting me on the air.
Richard Reggio, graduated in 1957. I have 4 children, 11 grandchildren, and I'm retired. Thank you.
Tony Cinquemano, class of 55, retired from Coppers Furniture, still married to the same lovely woman for 49 years. Thank you very much.
Charlie Mayer, class of 55, retired.
Sal Patera, class of 55, retired.
I'm Felix Shetter, I graduated in 55. I'm retired now and I live in Diamond Head, Mississippi.
Sal Masmisi, class of 1955, retired 3 years ago. We married this year, 50 years.
Joe DiGiovanni, I'm retired, class of 55, enjoying it every minute.
I'm Milton Campo from the class of 55, and since he's still working, I'm still working too, so I haven't retired yet. I work for a company with engineering conveyor equipment. Enjoying it every day of my life. You know who you
are? Jim McDowell, 55, retired, doing nothing. Thank you.
Vincent Gattuso, I'm still employed, working for the St. Bernard Parish School Board. I'm the transportation coordinator. Class of 1955.
I'm John Carbo, class of 56. I had the opportunity to play with Charles Illanne, who was the finest quarterback that the Holy Cross ever had, and I hope that someday in the next world we can do it again.
Phil Perenni, class of 56, semi-retired, former insurance agent.
I'm Ray Brian Cheney, graduated 1955. I'm a retired All-State agent. Now all I do is play golf every day that ends in Y.
Lester Lubat, class of 54, retired.
Charles Illanne, class of 55, retired.
Joe Scafidi, I'm a retired All-State agent, 43 years with All-State. It's a privilege to be here with all these guys each month.
Ted Kringer, class of 55, air conditioning business, retired.
Hill Wagner, class of 1955. I'm retired now. I used to work for NOPSI, but all I do is fish, eat, and take care of my grandchildren.
I'm Ray Hanley. I was class of 1955. I spent 20 years in the Marine Corps, 22 years with the aerospace business, and I don't do a thing.
Gordon Smith, class of 55. The craziest one in the whole class.
My name's Bob Masett, class of 1955. I'm a Catholic priest, and I'm doing my best to save these suckers.
This man to my left, I'm hoping is going to live about 30 more years, because one of my last wishes is that he do the job when I got to be buried. My name is Lloyd Bosch, who went to St. Cecilia's with your father, Charlie Illanne, and I've been knowing him all of his life and mine too. Not a bad guy after you get to know him a while.
Charlie Pomez, class of 56. I'm a retired elevator mechanic. And this guy that just spoke to you all, he's lying. The reason he wants him to live, that's only one of his confession.
I'd like to ask us to remember a couple of people who recently passed away. First is Augie Lanassa. Earl is passing a card around, if you'd sign it for his family. Also, Ronnie Fernandez, class of 1956. And James McCune, who was in our class, passed away about 3 weeks ago. And also, we'd ask you to remember Jimmy Champagne's son-in-law, who died last night and will be buried on Saturday.
What was his name?
I don't remember his name.
Roland Kerr's son is being awake
okay.
Today.
Yes.
What's his name? Roland Kerr.
And, Pat Lynch and Roland Kerr's son was it Gregory?
Gregory, yes.
Gregory Kerr. Okay. All right, and we're really thankful too that some guys are back on their feet, like Red LaCroix. He's about to make an invention to play golf. Even after he drinks those old fashions, I don't know what to do. And Joe Delaney, glad to see Joe. And Roy Phelps is back, but he had heart surgery.
Yeah, there he is right there.
I didn't know he had a heart surgery. Gordon Smith is drinking beer again. His favorite song, Three Cheers for the Red, White, and Blue. He's doing all right over there. Okay.
And Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Father, once again, we thank you. We thank you for the gift of the first Thursday of this month. We thank you for those of us who are able to make it, and we pray for those that couldn't make it. Father, we ask your blessing upon this meal, upon each and every person here and their families. And we can always, Lord, the things that we do with one thing in mind, and that's to glorify you, Daddy. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hi, I'm Lyman Mate, class of 56. I was self-employed, and I've been retired for the last 2 years.
Frank Fidella, class of 58. I've been retired for the past 2 years. I'm retired from Avondale Shipyards after 40 years of service. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Rich Mate, class of 51. Went to LSU 4.5 years. Got out in 1956. I have 2 sons, and we all live in Metairie.
Hi, I'm Earl Magna, class of 51. I'm a retired civil engineer, but I work part-time for St. Tammany Parish. God bless you.
Richard Crosby. I was a school teacher and a professional musician. I taught most of these guys here.
A.J. P.Q. in the class of 52, and I was in transportation. I retired 3 years ago.
This is Buddy Schiro, class of 56. You probably don't remember. And I'm Herb Lackerson, class of 57.
The only thing I'm doing is spending my kids' inheritance. That's all I'm doing is spending all their money and having a good time doing it.
But absolutely, buddy. Say goodnight. Say goodnight, buddy.
Say goodnight, Herb. Goodnight, Herb.
Hello, this is Dave Hinkle, class of 1955, one of the 50-year Golden graduate boys. Nice talking to you.
Pat Dorian, class of 53, and right now I'm not doing much of anything. I'm retired, been retired for about 5 years.
I'm Ken Vecker, class of 53. I'm a practicing orthopedic surgeon, soon to retire in the next 2 months.
Joe Scartina, class of 57, banking.
Dave Beach, class of 57, retired.
John Hantel, class of 55, and I'm an attorney, hopefully going to retire someday.
Johnny Brechtel, class of 58. I'm retired from everything, thank God.
I'm Bill Johnson. I'm from what's known as the greatest generation. I graduated in 1941. Worked for Eastern Airlines for 43 years before I retired.
Rodney Williams, class of 53, and retired from everything and having a good time here.
Hi, I'm Don Macenter, graduated year 53, retired from the Orleans Parish Criminal Sheriff's Office. I'm glad to see everybody.
Hi, I'm Jack Kushler, and I graduated in 1953. And just retired from work and enjoying life, and good luck to the class of 55.
Butch Zimmerman, class of 1950, and I enjoyed my stay at Holy Cross, and I'm enjoying this luncheon here with all the guys.
Cyril Helmer, class of 1954. Wonderful being here. Worked at American Standard 32 years. Now I'm retired and have enjoying life. Have a good one.
Bob Beck, class of 53. I'm retired owner of a construction company, and all I do is hunt and fish.
Sonny Clark, class of 1954, retired life insurance business.
But since you've been
thanks for taking me on a one-way trip to the sun. Thanks for turning me into someone.
Felix Cheddar, I graduated in 55 and I'm retired now.
Who aged the most?
I'd have to say St. Anthony.
St. Anthony?
Yeah, you know who that is. That's right. He's old. He was always old.
My name is Jose Jimenez.
Come on, goofball. What's your name?
My name is L.A. Dosri.
Where you graduated?
I graduated in 35. No, that's when I was born.
No, 35?
55.
Okay. And when you retired?
I retired in 56.
Okay. You use Viagra?
No, Jade. I got a bad heart.
Who's the ugliest person in your class?
My brother.
And your name?
My name is Tony Cinquemano.
You graduated?
1955.
What you do?
I don't do anything but sit down on the porch with my little dog and rub her belly all day long.
And what you do with your computer?
My computer crashed on me today, so I'm going to jump the bridge tonight.
And tell me, do you use Viagra?
I used to, but now that I take the blood pressure pills, I can't take them anymore.
Joe Scortina, 57.
Marvin Cavallino, 55.
Okay, so who's the ugliest guy in your class?
Not one of us, that's for sure. We're the two best looking ones. Let the camera tell the tale.
All right.
My name is Charles Illanne. I'm retired. However, I'm working. I graduated in 1955 with your father, your uncle, and all these other people here, except at this table, there's a whole group out.
And who do you think looks the oldest out of your graduate class?
Me.
Here, you graduated?
My name's Luke Coniglio, graduated 1954.
What do I do?
I'm retired from General Motors. I've been retired since 1986 and enjoying every day of it.
How many kids you have?
5 kids and 17 grandchildren.
Oh, Lord.
So, and enjoying all of them.
Give us the name, the year you graduated.
My name is Bob Masett. I graduated in 1955. In the golden years of Holy Cross. I'm really happy to be here tonight and see all my classmates and all the suckers that were so bad I had to give my life to save them. And I'm after them, and they better get their envelopes ready because I got their phone number now.
And how many of the next generation did you marry of their kids?
I must have married at least 50 or 60 of them. I'm glad they had you all. It kept me in business for quite a while. I got a new set of golf clubs and all kind of stuff going for me because of that. Baptized all the grandkids. And it's just been a great life. I wouldn't trade with anybody. Go Tigers.
My name is Raymond Bianchini, 1955. Me age the most in my class?
Who's the oldest one?
Tony Cinquemano. He was 2 years older than me to start with. I didn't realize how old he was till we got out of school. He was 19 when I was 16.
Okay. And how many children do you have?
I have 4 children and 10 grandchildren.
Keep you busy, huh?
Yeah, keep my wife busy. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful
now
grandchildren.
I have a very personal question to ask you.
Uh-oh.
Viagra?
No.
No?
No.
That'll kill you.
The only time I tried it, I thought it was killing me. I'm not lying. I'm not lying. I don't use Viagra.
Wait a
minute. See Big Bad John right there? He'd still be at Holy Cross if he wasn't looking over my shoulder. He'd still be there. And look, and Big Al be busting his ass. I'm going to tell you right now. Big Al be busting him, I tell you that. You still be there. Where's Big Al? Big Al still alive? Yeah, man, I'll tell you what. I love you, Big Daddy. I love you, Big Daddy.
What are we doing, baby? My name is Rock Hudson. I've been here before. This is my second trip. It's nice to be amongst all these friends, good-looking old friends, some of them very old. Get this profile on this thing right here. And the question about Viagra, I'll answer that honestly. I use Viagra. I use the pump. I got the insert. I got anything that'll help. And I pray over it at night.
These six people you see up here, one Tuesday or Monday, decide to have lunch, Chinese food. Father Bob treated so we didn't get nothing to eat. We decided to do something with the Holy Cross Alumni Class of 55. I think we have a nice turnout tonight. We have other class members that are here that wanted to get on the bandwagon with the Ninth Ward. I want to thank everybody for coming. I have a few things we want to do tonight. First of all, Donna, would you pass this out to these guys for me?
It's
a little gift for you all. Okay, we got five ladies that busted their tails for this thing tonight. They made stuff, gifts to give out. They made the name tags. They did a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I'd like to bring them up here and congratulate them and thank them. I need Don and Neil up here. Michelle Shellhouse. Who are you? Colin, Donna, and Terry. What a great thing you want to talk to your meal. Now, Father Bob's going to lead us in a song.
The Holy Cross went to formal in 1954. Except drinking holy water is legal. You don't have to go to the car every 15 minutes. Secondly, there will be no smooching on the dance floor. And there will be no dancing on the smooch floor. Okay, and confessions will be heard in the parking lot in case you get wound up in a motel. But we want to sing the Holy Cross fight song, and we also have Pat O'Brien's version of it. So, and then after that, we'll be general dancing, and all you guys who cannot qualify for the Glee Club at Holy Cross, we're going to test you out later on with some Christmas carols. We've got all the books. So, let's go with the guys. Here we go.
We sober up on good alcohol. While the loyal faculty lies out on the barroom floor.
Cheer for the Holy Cross. Cheer in victory, cheer in loss. Send the valley, cheer on high. Shake down and thunder from the sky. Whether the odds be great or small, the Holy Cross will win over all. While our loyal sons will march in onward to victory.
Girls, would y'all come up again? I got just one announcement more. Our next Thursday dinner will be right here on Thursday, January the 6th. So please try to make it. And if you look way ahead for the class of 55, graduation is May 21st, 2005. There's a mass at 9 in the morning at Holy Cross, and the graduation is at 3 in the afternoon at UNO. And you will get a gold diploma, so try to write that down.
Good morning. Welcome to the 2005 Holy Cross Baccalaureate Mass. Our celebrant this morning is Monsignor Robert Masett. Monsignor Masett is the pastor of St. Mary Magdalene Parish and a true friend of Holy Cross, and in fact a Holy Cross man, as a member of the class of 1955. Monsignor Masett was a celebrant for our ring mass last August and appropriately joins us again today. A day that is personally special to him as well, since he will receive his golden anniversary certificate at our commencement this afternoon. After we welcome our celebrant with the opening hymn, we ask that you be seated for the 2005 salutatory address to be delivered by salutatorian Michael John Boucher. Now please stand and greet Monsignor Masett as the Holy Cross Chorus sings our opening hymn, Praise His Holy Name.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them, and none of them was lost except the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in your truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I sent them into the world. And I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord. When I was about 18 years old, my father brought in a picture of an old geezer. And he said, boy, take a good look at this. This is your grandpa. And one day you're gonna look exactly like him. Well, if you guys turn around and look in this upper deck behind you, that's what you're gonna look like in 2055, just like we do in 1955. And even though we now come in various shapes and sizes, we still are a pretty good band of brothers. And I would be honored to do anything with any of these guys. And thanks to L.A. Dotrieve and his brother J.F., they have really kept us together over the 50 years, always conscious of our roots here at Holy Cross. And this morning, we are very much aware of the brothers and the teachers who really sacrifice themselves for us. We're aware also of our parents who managed to come up somehow with $12 a month for 9 months to pay the tuition for us to be here. And we're conscious too of the 25 or 26 classmates who have now gone on to meet the Lord face to face. What I'd like to share with you guys this morning are the words and the thoughts of a real Holy Cross man. His name is Father Theodore Hesburgh, CSC, who was president of the University of Notre Dame for many, many, many years. And I'm especially proud to use these words and thoughts this morning because when I heard him speak them, he was really laying it on heavy to the graduates of Loyola and putting the Jesuits in their place. And what he said to these Loyola graduates, I think are true for all time. He said to them, I know over the last 4 years, you have been concentrating on certain letters, like A's and B's and C's, in order to get your diploma. But I would challenge you with three C's that will be the key and the answer to your life. First of all, he said, you must be competent. You cannot make it in this world if you're not competent. And I think this is where our Holy Cross motto of boys to men really comes in. The world today needs competent men and women if it's going to handle all of the challenges that are out there. We really cannot send adolescents to do the jobs that need adults. And so I challenge you now to be a man and to throw away the things of adolescence as soon as possible. The second C is committed. He told these graduates that the world needs people who not only are going to talk about things, but who are really going to do them and to accomplish them. And I think this is where our school code comes in. All of the features and qualities of the Holy Cross man, someone concerned about his soul, someone devoted to Mary and Joseph, someone who wants to be a useful person in the world, someone who is a person of honor, someone who keeps his word, especially in the business world, and especially in the marriage vows. And the third C is compassion. That people not just live their lives for mercenary reasons, but people who really exemplify the love and compassion of Jesus himself in the occupation they choose and in their approach to things. And this is where I think the motto of the Holy Cross brothers comes in. Crux spes unica, the cross is the only hope, meaning the total unconditional love of Jesus himself shining through the person who tries to be another Christ. I think this also fits the scripture readings which we used this morning, that the word of God is in us, as Moses said, but we need to do it. I hope it makes us good shepherds of families and neighborhoods, as Paul sent his people. And I hope that we will always consecrate ourselves, like Jesus did, for the good of others. And I'd like to just close with an experience that I had about 2 weeks ago when we went to award the Regina Matrum Award to a lady in Our Lady of Divine Providence Parish. She is the mother of three children who have been severely handicapped since birth, with a rare blood disease. The oldest is now about 29, the second is 27, and the third is about 24. Her whole life has been dedicated to caring for these children, She and her husband have done a wonderful job, and now he has multiple sclerosis. And so she is going to be a caretaker for him. And when she received the award, the words that she spoke sounded very much like the Holy Cross man. And she said something like, when my husband and I got married, we had tremendous dreams of the perfect family. But now, after this wonderful experience of life, we have discovered the perfect family that God has chosen for us. So, my fellow classmates, today we're going to offer this Mass for you, that you stay loyal to each other, that you stay in touch, and hopefully not make this the last time you're together, that you stay in touch with Boys to Men, the Holy Cross man, and the cross approach as the only hope, that you too, in the midst of all the dreams you have of the perfect life, that you find the perfect life that God has chosen for you. Please stand for the prayers of the faithful.
Deliver us, Father, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety as we await in joyful hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Lord is now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. On this happy morning, let us offer each other a sign of the Lord's peace. Joy that Jesus promises those who follow him.
This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace and celebrate this day and love and serve the Lord.
Good evening. I'd like to take a few moments and ask you to join in prayer for a prayer that was written by myself and classmate Scott White. Dear Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Dear Lord, thank you only begins to describe the amount of things we have to get up on this stage today and walk off a Holy Cross grave. You bless us all with a special gift that is in us deep inside. A gift of Holy Cross brotherhood that will be with us till we die. Through your grace, you put a group of young boys together, and those boys, now men, have made a band of brothers that will last forever. Forever it will always be, and it will always be alive. So thank you, Lord, for bringing us together, and bless the class of 2005. Amen. Father, Son.
Thank you.
tradition of the Holy Cross commencement is a recognition of the graduation class celebrating the 50th anniversary of its commencement exercise at Holy Cross. Today we recognize the members of the class of 1955 who are sharing this special day with the class of 2005. Presenting the Golden Anniversary Certificates to the members of the class of 55 are Headmaster Mr. Charles DeGange, Principal Dr. Joseph Murray, and Chairman of the Holy Cross Board of Directors, Mr. Clancy Dubos, who is a member of the class of 1972.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed a great pleasure for me to present to call the names of the Golden Anniversary Certificates. Raymond Biaccini. Lloyd J. Bosch, Jr. John A. Brogy. Marvin Cavallino. Walter Champagne. Felix Chetta. Hubert Chasson, Jr. Anthony Cinquemano. Leo W. Cooper, Jr. Robert Cousins. Thomas C. Cross. James F. Dotrieve, Jr. Leon A. Dotrieve. Joseph R. DiGiovanni. Joseph A. Fabra, Jr. Joseph R. Francis, Jr. Vincent S. Gattuso, Jr. Ray Hanley. John L. Hantel. David H. Hinkle. Charles F. Illanne. Monsignor Robert D. Masett. John McLachlan. Salvador J. Musmenchi. Salvador A. Portera Jr. Renee F. Husegura Jr. Frederick Rappel. Earl H. Schneider, Jr. U. J. Smith. Rodney M. Trentadue. Eric J. Vospin. Hildreth Z. Wagner, Jr. Albert Wiedenbacher. Leslie H. Wellmeyer, Jr. Charles J. Wolfe. We have held three golden anniversary certificates out of alphabetical order to present at this time for a special reason. Tradition and legacy are very important aspects of Holy Cross School. It is only once every 3 years that this situation happens at our commencement. Three of the members of the class of 1955 are grandfathers of four of the members of today's graduating class. It is for this reason that we ask Christopher Piazza, Paul Piazza, Sean Santos, and Benjamin Wineski to come join their grandfathers, Vincent Piazza, Earl Santos, and Louis Wineski on stage at this time. Christopher and Paul will now present the Golden Anniversary Certificate to their grandfather, Vincent P. Piazza, Jr. Please remain on stage, gentlemen. Please remain on stage. Sean Santos will now present the Golden Anniversary Certificate to his grandfather, Colonel Earl P. Santos. And Benjamin will now present the Golden Anniversary Certificate to his grandfather, Louis Wineski. And now it is only fitting that Mr. Piazza present the 2005 Holy Cross Diploma to his grandsons, Christopher Michael Piazza and Paul Rene Piazza, Jr. And now Colonel Santos will present the 2005 Holy Cross Diploma to his grandson, Sean Patrick Santos. Sorry, we missed one. Congratulations. And now, Colonel, if you would present the diploma to Sean Patrick Santos. Congratulations. And now, Louis Wineski will present the 2005 Holy Cross Diploma to his grandson, Benjamin Christopher Wineski. Congratulations to the family legacies of Holy Cross men and the Piazza, Santos, and Wineski families, and to all the members of the class of 1955. Congratulations, gentlemen.
Will be the only person that